What's going on, guys? This is Chandler Smith, and in this video, I'm gonna show you how much money I make off of 99 units of rental real estate. I'm also gonna show you how I was able to acquire all of these units while in my 20s. So with all of that being said, let's jump into it. All right, guys, over the last couple months, I've gotten two questions over and over again. The first question is, Chandler, you're at 99 units of rental real estate. Why don't you just freaking buy one more unit? And my answer is, I probably should, but I'm holding off because I'm working on a big deal. So I promise you, it's going to be worth the wait, and I'm going to fly past that 100 unit mark. The other question I get asked a lot is, Chandler, how much do you actually make off of 99 units of rental real estate? And so in this video, I'm gonna try and be completely transparent and show you exactly what I make every single year off of all of these units. I'm also gonna share with you some of the tips and tricks I've used to not only find and acquire these properties, but make sure they're paying me the best return. Now, I hesitate to do videos like this because it can definitely be perceived as arrogance, and that's not my goal at all. The reason I did this video is I love sharing with people the actual numbers. I love them being able to see, wow, if I invest in real estate properly, this is where I can get. This is the return I can make. This is the passive income that I can build. And so again, I hope you don't take this in the wrong way. I'm sure there are gonna be people that go and leave nasty comments or say negative things. But if you're not one of those people, I'd really appreciate it if you smash the like button, subscribe to the channel, and hit the little bell. It helps the algorithm, and it really helps the algorithm if you leave a comment. Ask me a question about real estate because I love seeing what questions you have that I haven't addressed in my other videos. And I promise you, if I see a good question, I will address it in the future. First off, you need to understand that there are four different ways that I make money in buy and hold real estate. All right, there's cash flow, there's principal pay down, there's appreciation, and there's tax benefits. I'm gonna go through each one of these and show you how much money I make in each, but you need to understand that some of this money is cash in my pocket, like cash I get every single month that is mine. However, a good chunk of this money is just an increase to my net worth. And what I mean by this is its value in the property that I can't take out unless I refinance the property or sell the property. And I'm gonna talk about why neither one of those options are always the right option for your situation, because you've kinda gotta time them up and make sure that you're refinancing or selling at the right times. A lot of the numbers I'm talking about are legitimate returns on my money, but they're not something that's super liquid. I can only get access to them if I refinance or if I sell the property. So keep that in mind, and I'll talk about which return is which. So the first one I'm gonna talk about is cash flow. And I'm just gonna be honest with you, cash flow is my favorite. And I think the reason that cash flow is my favorite is I made a rule that whatever I make in cash flow off my rental properties, that's what I get to spend on my lifestyle. So the more cash flow that I have, the greater my lifestyle is. Not necessarily. My lifestyle is great either way, but I get to spend more money towards my house, my cars, all of those things. And so I love building a massive income through cash flow. Now, if you don't know what cash flow is, essentially it's just taking your rental income in and then all of your expenses. So any expenses on the property, management fees, taxes, insurance, and your mortgage insurance out, and whatever you're left with, that's your cash flow. It's money in your pocket that you can spend, and it's freaking awesome. So on my 99 units of rental real estate, I make $17,647 in cash flow every single month. That's over $211,000 in cash flow that I make off of my units every single year. And that $211,000 mark, that's what I use to determine what my lifestyle is. So that goes towards my car payments, towards my house payments, and towards any of my other living expenses. The next way that I make money off of these 99 units is through principal pay down. Now, if you don't know it already, on every single one of my units, I have a loan. And if you're asking, Chandler, Why on earth would you have a loan on every property? Why wouldn't you just start paying properties off? You need to go and watch this video because I will sell you super hard on why you should never pay off your properties but always have a loan on them. So go check that out. We're gonna skip right over it, but keep in mind on every one of my properties, I have a loan. Now in the cash flow section, we talked about how you take out your mortgage as an expense. So your mortgage has already been taken out, but when you pay your mortgage every single month, there's a portion of that mortgage that goes towards interest, and there's a portion of it that goes towards principal. Now the principal portion is paying down what you actually own on that property, which means you're actually getting more of your money tied up in that property. So that is a legitimate return. That is money that's essentially being put into a bank account that is your property. And so at this point, I own 99 units where every single month I'm paying a mortgage and I'm getting principal pay down. As a matter of fact, on my 99 units, I currently get $9,952 every single month in principal pay down. That's over $119,000 every single year that I'm making in principal pay down. And here's the cool part. As you continue to pay down your loan, you pay less and less in interest and more in principal pay down. So not only am I getting $119,000 plus every single year in principal pay down, but it's just that, it's plus, because every single year, that number is going to get bigger and bigger. Now, I know there are going to be a lot of haters out there that say, well, Chandler, that money's locked up. You can't get access to it unless you refinance or 1031 exchange or sell the property and just take the cash. And so that seems kind of hairy as a return. Well, here's the deal. It's a legitimate return. And people will argue, well, what if the property goes down in value? On average, if you buy in the right place, property is always going up in value. Okay, so when people say, oh, what if it goes down? It's always going to rebound. It's always going to go back up. And that's why I love principal pay down, is it forces you to leave that money in there. It forces you to hold on to that return, even when things do drop, so that you can hold on to it. And down the road, when your property is worth way more and you have the property paid off, that is a fat return that you can have access to. This segues perfectly into the next way that I make money off of my 99 units, and that is through appreciation. Now, here's the deal with appreciation. People say that the average appreciation is between 3 and 5%, but you can actually force appreciation on your property. For example, I bought a 32-plex here in the last year, and that 32-plex, I went in, I did renovations, and I raised rents drastically. As a matter of fact, I raised them so drastically that that $2.1 million property is now worth over $3 million if I decided to sell it. Now, I know this sounds crazy, but that is forced appreciation. And so I'm not gonna run the numbers on forced appreciation. Did I make almost $1 million off of that property in 1 year because of appreciation? Yes, I did. But for the sake of these numbers, I am only going to run appreciation based off of a 5% increase on all of my properties every single year. So at only a 5% appreciation, I make $36,250 every single month. That ends up being over $435,000 every single year. Now, again, I know there will be naysayers and haters that say, Chandler, that's not a legitimate return. You can't just get access to it. The market might dip. Well, here's the deal. Year after year here in Idaho, property values have exploded. So 5% is like sickeningly conservative, especially considering what I've done with some of the properties to raise rents and force massive appreciation. I was considering running this number at 15% instead of 5, but I knew people would give me all kinds of flack. And so I'm running it at just 5 because here is the deal. Property values always go up. They're gonna have dips, but they're consistently going up. So as long as you don't sell in a dip, and even if you do sell in a dip, you're still gonna capitalize on appreciation. But if you're smart and you wait until the right time to sell or 1031 exchange or refinance, you can win huge on appreciation. And I think that 5% is actually understated. If you're buying properties properly, forcing appreciation, buying in areas that you know property values are going up, this number is absurdly conservative. All right, now we're gonna move into the fourth way that you make money by investing in real estate, and that is through tax benefits. And this category is insane because there are so many different ways that you make or essentially save on taxes by investing in real estate. The first one is you've got your cash flow. Because I'll make $211,000 in cash flow, that means that I will save $78,353 a year in taxes. That ends up being $6,529 every single month that I save or essentially earn because I'm not having to pay taxes on the income I made on my cash flow from investing in real estate. Now, those are the only numbers I'm going to use for the total example. However, you've also got principal pay down and appreciation that you've made an income that you're not paying any taxes on. Now, I'm not gonna do the math on these because the numbers are absolutely insane, and I'm not gonna do them because you do have to pay taxes on those returns if you sell the property, but here's what the government has done. They've gifted you this thing that is called a 1031 exchange, which means when you sell your property, you can have all of that money put with a third party until you go and buy another property. And if you just move that principal pay down and that appreciation from one property into another property, you don't have to pay tax on it. That's why 1031 exchanges are incredible. And that's why I'll never sell a property to just get cash. I'll continue to use that principal pay down, that appreciation, and whatever down I had in my previous property to just flip into bigger and better properties. That means every 5 to 10 years, if I decide to sell these properties, I won't have to pay taxes on all of these returns, but I can use that money to buy a bigger property that's going to give me bigger appreciation, bigger principal pay down, and bigger cash flow, which in turn is going to yield bigger tax benefits. And so the government has given you these loopholes that they know about so that you can save huge money. Now, I can't go into all of the tax savings on all that other stuff, but we're gonna focus just on the tax savings you get on your cash flow, which again was over $78,000 per year. That means I get $17,647 in cash flow, $9,952 in principal pay down, $36,250 in appreciation, and I get $6,529 in tax benefits with a fat plus sign next to it because it's actually way more than that. So if you add all of these together, that's $70,378 that I make from investing in real estate every single month. That means that by investing in these 99 units of rental real estate, I make over $844,000 every single year. So for those of you that were asking, I hope this video helps. Now you know exactly how much I make off of 99 units of rental real estate. But the cool part that I don't think I've emphasized enough in this video is the fact that every single year, this number will get bigger, even if I don't purchase any more real estate, because appreciation is going to get bigger. If you had a property worth $100,000 and it went up to $105,000, now you're gonna get 5% off of that $105,000. On top of that, your principal pay down is getting bigger every single year. On top of that, the market is expanding, and so your rents should be increasing every single year. And when it comes to the tax side of things, if you use those strategies properly, you should be able to capitalize bigger and bigger on those tax benefits. And so I've said it before and I'll say it again, there is no better investment than investing in real estate. Now, a lot of people will ask, Chandler, well, is this consistent with any 99 units? And I think this point is a huge one that I need to make. It is so crucial that you know the numbers that you're looking for before you invest in real estate. Just buying property is not going to get you to these numbers. It is so crucial that you hold to the desired return that you want. And once you find it, then you jump on it and you start building your portfolio. But if I had to pick out one thing that helped me to get here while I was in my 20s, it was that I found a job to where I could maximize my earnings, and I put the majority, if not all of those earnings, into buying more real estate. Now, all of my active income goes into buying real estate. Early on, I lived super frugally so I could put the majority of my active income towards real estate, but now I put all of it in because I want to continue to build my portfolio. And so if you can maximize your earnings on the front end with whatever job you're doing, find a side hustle, find a way to get a commission job, find a way to maximize your income, and then spend as little of it as possible and put all of the rest into real estate, that's one huge tip that'll help you get there. The other big tip is hold to your numbers. For me, I need to get my 15% cash on cash return while in a market that I know is also getting huge appreciation. So if you follow those two rules, if you maximize your earnings and you hold to your desired return, I promise you it's not that difficult to get to this point where you can be raking it in off of a passive income through investing in real estate. Now, if you want to know more about how to invest in real estate, there's obviously a lot that goes into it. And that's why I created a course that is over 9 hours that gives you a step-by-step process on how to scale from no rental properties to over 100 doors of rental real estate. So click the link below. Right now, you can get $50 off of that course. And if you don't want to spend the money on a course, even though I've definitely worked hard to make sure the course is worth it, just make sure you remember to smash that like button, subscribe to my channel, and hit the little bell, because on this channel, I'm gonna do everything I can to give you the information you need to build a huge passive income. Thanks so much, guys, and have a great day.